Good morning. We are going to discuss a heat conduction with a chemical heat source. So here we are considering a fixed bed flow reactor with a radius capital R. Okay, so this reactor contains three zones, or this reactor is divided into three parts: first zone, second zone, and third zone. Okay, and the direction of the reactant or fluid flow and inside inward, and the product is exiting from zone third. Okay, so wall of this reactor is insulated, and first zone contains a non-catalytic particles, and zone second contains a catalyst, so that is known as the reaction zone. Okay, which varies from Z equals to 0 to Z equals to L. And third zone, exit zone, packed with non-catalytic spheres or particles. So in this zone, there is no chemical reactions. Generally, chemical reactions are taken place in zone second. Okay, so here we are considering a small thickness of zone second, delta Z. Okay, and the fluid which is flowing in this zone has a velocity V naught. So V naught equals to Wy pi R square rho. So this velocity is also known as the superficial velocity. So here we have assumed something like density, mass flow rate, and superficial velocity are all treated as independent of R and Z. These don't depend on R and Z. And second point, the reactor wall is assumed to be well insulated. Okay, so that temperature can be considered independent of R. Okay, chemical reactions occur, thermal engineering. Thermal energy is produced or consumed when the reactant molecules are rearranged to form the products. Okay, and here we are considering a SC. SC is the rate of energy production for unit volume. So here we are considering a small differential thickness delta Z of a catalyst zone. Okay, so now we are going to write an energy valence, like rate of total energy in at Z. At Z means it is here at Z. This is Z, and this is Z plus delta Z. Okay, so rate of total energy in at Z minus rate of total energy out at Z plus delta Z plus rate of energy production equals to zero. This is the energy balance equation. Okay, so EZ at Z, so here EZ is the combined energy flux vector. So if we multiply this flux vector by area, so it will give the energy flow rate or heat flow rate. So if we multiply this by pi r square, which is the area of a reaction zones, circular area of a reaction zones, minus pi r square Ez at Z plus delta Z plus pi r square delta Z, is the volume of a circular zone, multiplied by SC, okay, heat transfer, heat production for unit volume, equals to zero. So this is the energy balance equation in a mathematical form. Now we will divide this equation by pi r square delta Z. So we will get equation Ez at Z plus delta Z minus Ez at Z divided by delta Z equals to SC. Now we will take the limit delta Z tends to 0 and apply the definition of first derivative. So we will get equation third, dEz by dZ equals to SC. Okay, so substitute the value of Ez into equation third, so we will get equation fourth, d by dz bracket 1 by 2 rho v square plus rho h cap vz plus tau zz vz plus qz equals to SC, where rho is the density of fluid, v is the velocity of fluid, and h is the enthalpy, vz is also velocity of a fluid, plus tau zz is a normal series.